हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू मरीन इंजीनियरिंग हब। दिस इज नरेटर रवि गुप्ता। टुडे वी गोना टॉक अबाउट सिलेंडर कंट्रोल यूनिट एंड ऑक्सिलरी कंट्रोल यूनिट। दिस इज द पार्ट 3 ऑफ द मेन इंजन कंट्रोल सिस्टम। इन पार्ट 1 आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ द मेन इंजन ऑफ ME इंजन। इन पार्ट 2 आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट EICU एंड ECU and how the signal is in process and how the everything is controlled. And now today we'll talk about CCU and ACU. So as we know, the first question come to our mind that where is the cylinder control unit is located. So as I have told you in my earlier video that CCU is located in each individual cylinder unit. For example, if there are 6 units, then there will be 6 CCU unit is provided. So now the question come to our mind that like ECU A, ECU B, there is a one backup is provided that if one fail, the other will come online. Like ECU A, ECU B, if one fail, other will come in line. Like MOP same is there. Is it there for CCU? The answer is no. If in case of failure of CCU unit, individual unit fuel supply is cut off and exhaust valve is set to open position and that unit is isolated, no redundancy is provided as we have seen in case of EICU and ECU. So as I have told you, if any of the CCU unit means out of 6 cylinder unit, if suppose number 4 cylinder unit CCU fail, in that case we will have, it will automatically go to a fail safe mechanism and it will automatically open the exhaust valve and will cut off the fuel supply as there is no backup for CCU is provided. Now the question come to our mind that what is the function of CCU? So CCU send its signal which it received from ECU for FIVA valve actuation through channel 17, and depending upon its signal, the fuel injection and exhaust valve actuation is initiated. So as you can see, this is the CCU for each individual unit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, like that. And this is the FIVA valve, this is the FIVA valve. Okay, now the signal for FIVA valve actuation is sent through CCU by channel 17, and that signal which CCU sent will be received from ECU. Okay, and as the CCU will send the signal to FIVA valve, it will decide that how much amount of fuel will go for burning and when will the exhaust valve will open. So this is the function of CCU. CCU also send signal for starting valve and cylinder lubrication. Apart from that, it also sends signal for cylinder lubrication and starting air entering the cylinder unit. So in a synopsis, if someone asks that what is the function of CCU, you say the CCU has three functions. One is that CCU sends its signal from channel 17 to FIVA valve for fuel and exhaust valve actuation. Second, it also sends signal for starting air valve actuation and main engine cylinder lubrication. Okay, now this is the function of CCU. Okay, now let's talk about auxiliary control unit. So where the auxiliary control unit is provided, see there. Okay, now auxiliary control unit are basically three in number, 1, 2, 3. So let's see. auxiliary control unit control the hydraulic pressure of servo oil, which is being developed by mechanical hydraulic pressure unit. So basically, the auxiliary control unit is controlling the hydraulic pressure, which is being developed by the engine driven hydraulic pump. Okay, it controls the amount of pressure which is to be developed by the engine driven pump. ECU also control auxiliary blower 1 and auxiliary blower 2 and provide the start stop signal as per the scavenge pressure. Very important. So the ECU will decide when will the auxiliary blower will start and when will the auxiliary blower will stop. It will vary the hydraulic pressure of the hydraulic control unit. Okay, so if the speed is this slow ahead, at that time ECU will send signal to the blower to cut in, and when the speed is more than half, like full, in that case it will send the signal depending upon the scavenge pressure to cut off the blower. Okay, the signal for varying the hydraulic pressure is received from ECU. Depending upon the number of hydraulic pressure unit, the control is divided among ECU and ACU. So the number of hydraulic pressure unit, depending on that, the control is divided. Suppose there is 5 hydraulic pressure unit, then 3 unit is control is given to ECU A, B and C, and other 2 is controlled by ECU A and B. But here ECU control hydraulic pressure unit can be moved either ahead or astern direction. So basically, suppose here there are 5 hydraulic pump unit. So what will happen? 1, 2, 3. It will be given to the individual ECU, ECU A, B, C, and other 2 will be given to the ECU A and ECU B. But the ECU A and ECU B control hydraulic pressure unit will either move in ahead direction or in astern direction. But ECU control unit can move in both direction, both in ahead and in astern, depending upon the signal received, and can also vary the hydraulic pressure. 2 electrical hydraulic pressure unit is controlled by ECU A and ECU B. The electrical hydraulic pressure pump is controlled by ECU A and ECU B. The electric hydraulic pressure unit is provided to develop hydraulic pressure at starting. After engine has picked up speed, it is switched to mechanical hydraulic pressure unit. Okay, so basically, as you can see, this is the 3 pump provided here. Means this is the basically 1, 2, 3. This is a 3 axial piston pump which has been engine driven through a gear arrangement is provided, and this will provide the hydraulic pressure in the system for servo oil actuation. But when the engine is starting, at that time the hydraulic pressure cannot be fully be developed by this individual axial piston pump. So to provide as a backup and at helping at this time of starting, electrical control motor is provided, which will help the engine during the startup. As the engine will pick up the speed, it will be switched off, and this axial piston pump will come into the action. This hydraulic electrical startup pump is controlled by ECU A and ECU B. Now, if the engine hydraulic pump are 5 in number, then A, B, C will be controlled by ECU A, B, C, and other 2 will be controlled by ECU A or ECU B. Okay. So I hope now you understand how a auxiliary control unit is functioning. So if now somebody says to you that what is the function of auxiliary control unit, so you say that auxiliary control unit control scavenge pressure, it control the blower cut-in cut-off depending upon the scavenge pressure, it vary the hydraulic pressure, it control the electrical driven hydraulic pump, and it also can vary the hydraulic pressure along with the direction depending upon that which is received from the ECU. Okay, so I hope in this video you have understand that how ACU and CCU work. If you have any doubt, please do comment below. I will revert back to you. If you like the video, please hit the like button and please do subscribe. Please do subscribe and please share in your Facebook and WhatsApp group. It's a request to all of our marine friends to please do that. Be in home and be safe. Have a good day, friend.